The Control Center in iOS 18 is now completely customizable, allowing you to add third-party actions wherever you'd like. So in this video, I'm going to list 32 great Control Center apps, bonus points for cool animations, and some of the great built-in Control Center actions you can use right now. Links to all the apps are down in the video description, and be sure to subscribe because even more iOS 18 content is coming soon. First, be sure you've updated to iOS 18. It's available now to everyone. Have some dark and large icons here, and now when you swipe down to get to the Control Center, you can tap and hold and go into editing mode. This lets you add custom actions and even resize certain actions. Plus, there's multiple pages now, and you can have as many pages as you'd like of custom Control Center actions down here. Once you've filled up your pages, you can tap Add a Control at the bottom, choose another Control Center action, and it will just add an entire other page at the bottom. Then you can quickly swipe between the pages by dragging your finger up and down that right side. And the first app that's taken a spot on my main Control Center screen is Shareshot. This is how I make some of the screenshots you see shared on social media. Choose a screenshot from your library, and it makes a beautifully designed card that you can then share on social media, reformat it to a different size, and hit the share button to save it to your camera roll, or just post it from the share sheet. I share a lot of screenshots, so having it right in the Control Center and jumps right to the app where I can choose a screenshot, really convenient. Number two, I'll go down to my custom page of actions, and Waterllama right here is a great app for tracking your water, and bonus points for really cool animations. When you add a control, you can search for an app up here, and Waterllama allows you to quickly track water right from the Control Center. You don't even have to open the app. You can choose to add water and then open the app, or just have an open app shortcut. And some Control Center actions from third-party apps, when you tap it in edit mode, actually gives you more options. So here you can choose what amount of water you're wanting to track in ounces, even what kind of animation you would like. Let's go with the circles and see what that looks like. Go back to the Control Center, out of edit mode, and again, pretty fun animation. Number three from the same developer is actually Mindllama, a great mindfulness app, and I love that you can have actions right here in Control Center, and it starts a live activity, doing a breathing exercise, and other options available. Really cool Control Center app and live activity in one. Again, bonus points for great design and fun animations. Number four, Dark Noise, which is a great white noise app. You can actually have controls right here and start playing rain sounds or other white noise sounds without even opening the app. Tap and hold to go into edit mode, and then you can tap that action and actually choose what sound you would like, the timer, and even enable long fade, all right here from the Control Center. Number five, this is actually a stock Control Center action, but Translate can actually live right here, and you can start a translation that lives in the dynamic island right now. Get the translation. This goes by the language currently set in the Translate app. You can play the audio right here, but a quick way to do an audio translation just right from Control Center. Another stock action is the Shazam Recognize Music. Just tap it here in Control Center. You don't even have to open the app, and it will recognize the music. Recognize it super fast, and then shows it to you in the dynamic island. Number seven, my beloved note-taking app, Bear, has a bunch of actions. I'll go into edit mode and actually search for it to show you everything available. But you can start a new note from Control Center, a new task note, capture something and add it to a note, or even document scanner, or search your Bear notes, all from Control Center actions. I actually chose to have the create note action live here, and when I tap that, it opens Bear and has me ready to start a new note that quickly. If you're a Carrot Weather fan, they have several actions. This takes you directly to the forecast for today, and you can also add an action for maps. I'll tap that, see it added it on one of my extra pages here, and now I can tap the maps icon, and that brings me directly to the radar map with my location. Number nine, I talked about this app in my widget roundup. You can check that video out above or the links in the description. But Cheatsheet is a nice way to just have a piece of information constantly visible. Let's say you travel often and you just want your current hotel number there. Well, Cheatsheet just lets you do that. And here in Control Center, and if you don't want it as a full widget, now you can just add a Cheatsheet item and add it as a Control Center action. Go into edit mode, and when you tap that, you can choose a different Cheatsheet item, and it'll just live there as a piece of information to remind you every time you look at it. Number 10, my favorite calendar app, Fantastical, has a bunch of actions available. You can just open the app, create an event, or even search your events all here from Control Center. I chose to put the create an event here, and now when I tap that, it automatically opens Fantastical, and I'm ready to start typing to create a new event. Next up is an app you probably know and love, but Widgetsmith now has incredibly powerful tools for customizing both widgets, your home screen, lock screen, and Control Center. Here in Widgetsmith, you can create multiple actions. I'll do add action, and this can include even messaging people, FaceTiming, calendar events, the weather, playing music, and if you don't feel like creating a bunch of shortcuts to open specific apps, Widgetsmith will just do it for you, and you can choose the icon that appears in Control Center. So I have a few actions here that I've created. One is to text my wife, this opens the Tesla app, and I can even start playing a playlist from a Control Center widget. So if I go to my Control Center, this is actually Widgetsmith right here, When I tap that, it'll just open the Tesla app. I can also go into edit mode, choose the Widgetsmith widget, and have access to all the widgets I created in the Widgetsmith app. I'll tap the Hans Zimmer station, and now we'll just start playing a Hans Zimmer playlist right here from Control Center. A nice way to just quickly play whatever playlist you'd like right from here. The next three actions are awesome third-party camera apps. Here I have Halide, Kino, their video recording app. Halide and Obscura have these already built in. You can just tap and hold, add the control, and there's a shortcut to open the Halide app. And here the app has been updated, so you can have a launch Obscura action right there. The makers of Kino said they're about to update the app and you'll have a shortcut built in, but right now I've actually just used a Widgetsmith action to open the app. It does go through Widgetsmith first, but it goes over pretty quickly. Same thing with the Halide action and Obscura right here. Also a quick note, any action that you can put in the Control Center, you can now put on your lock screen as well. So if I tap and hold, customize the lock screen, I can now swap out the main camera button and choose Obscura, Halide, or any other Control Center action I'd like. So if I search and put Halide now on my lock screen, I basically have access to two different cameras that fast. I can either swipe over and open the stock camera app, or I can tap and hold and open the Halide app right here. Now I can access two different cameras all from the lock screen that quickly. Number 15, my favorite app for tracking movies and books is Sofa. Sofa has a bunch of actions. Let me tap here. You can access your pile, which are just books, movies, and other things you've kind of saved quickly, pinned items, your logbook, which are movies or books that you've read and watched, or go to a specific list. And remember, once you're in edit mode, you can tap an action, like here's the sofa action, and you can choose what list you'd actually like to see. Now I can tap that Control Center action, it opens the Sofa app, and I quickly see the latest books I've read. Another great app for tracking movies and TV show is Sequel. I have that right here, next to Sofa. That'll open the app, and again, you can program what list that shortcut goes to. Next up is Drafts. I actually use Drafts a lot when I just want to write something down quickly to share on social media, and while it looks like it's just one action here in Drafts, there's actually a bunch of things you can do. So here I have a new draft button, but if I tap that in edit mode, you could see all these different options you have hidden under that Drafts action. Like every time I share a new episode of Primary Technology, I start that post here in Drafts, which by the way, you should totally listen to Primary Tech. Link is above and down in the description. But I've chosen this action just to be a new draft, so I can tap it quickly, it opens drafts to a blank slate, and I can start writing and quickly share that wherever I'd like. Number 18, if you're a big HomeKit user like I am, there's an entire page here in Control Center for all your home actions, scenes, individual items, but you can have these added anywhere as well. Tap and hold, add a control, and you can have a particular scene or accessory, a shortcut to the actual home app, or my favorite widget is one where you can actually have multiple items at a time. Tap it, and if you uncheck the use recommended, now you can actually add multiple items or multiple scenes. I'll add a bunch right here. And now you have multiple actions or scenes. And many actions here in Control Center are actually resizable just by clicking and dragging the corner. So if I make this an even larger widget, now I can add more scenes or more accessories and really customize all my home controls. Number 19, a great third-party app for customizing widgets and shortcuts is Lock Launcher. I use this to create some custom icons for my lock screen widgets before, and as you can see, lots of options either to quickly run shortcuts, open apps, controls, all that kind of stuff. If you really want to customize your iPhone, I recommend trying Lock Launcher. Number 20, there's an app called Gentler Streak, which can help if you're trying to get into fitness or have a streak of any kind. Gentler Streak is a nice way, lots of encouragement. I covered this in my widget video roundup as well. Another great app from underscore David Smith, who makes the app Widgetsmith, is Pedometer Plus Plus. You can now have actions here in the Control Center, see how many steps you've walked for the day, and there's also great widgets and Apple Watch widgets for Pedometer Plus Plus. Highly recommend. Number 22, there's an action called Scan Words, which is actually from this app called LookUp. It's pretty cool. If you use this Control Center action, it opens the camera and actually lets you scan a word. So let's see if I can get this in the scan part right there. Helpful if you're like reading something and want to quickly look up a definition. Well, you can quickly scan a word, tap in, and then it'll open the app, quickly give you the meaning. Really cool app. There's some pro features I don't pay for just yet. I just do definitions and things like that. Works great. Number 23, RainViewer has some really cool widgets with those radar maps and precipitation. They have a Control Center action. It basically just lets you open the app directly, hoping to add some other actions there, but I do really like their precipitation maps. Number 24, this little star icon here is Things. That's my favorite to-do app. Lots of customization here, and this will quick launch any of the lists in your Things app, and you can even filter by tags right here from the Control Center action. I have this opening my Today view, so when I tap the star, it goes directly to the Things app in the Today view. Number 25, if you use Spark as your third-party email application, there's great actions here going directly to compose a new email. I still haven't set it up yet. My co-host on Primary Tech, Jason Aitin, he loves it, but if you use Spark, great actions already available. Number 26, Streaks is a great app to keep track of how many days you've done something that you want to do routinely. And here you can choose what task in the Streaks app is here in the control center. Let's say you want to make sure you take your vitamins every day or write in your journal. It'll actually change the icon with whatever you have in Streaks, and I can tap it here in the control center to mark that I've done it. Number 27, one of the new iOS 18 features is Tap to Cache, which even happens anonymously. You don't even have to share your contact information anymore. And tapping that action brings you right to the Tap to Cache screen. It's a little cumbersome to get to this with the wallet app, so having a control center action makes it really convenient. Number 28, you probably knew you could ping your iPhone from your watch, but you can also ping your watch from your iPhone. Tap this control center action, and your watch makes a sound in case you have your phone, but maybe you lost your watch. Number 29, Tripsy lets you see your next trip that you have saved to the app, which it's just a great travel app overall if you want to keep track of hotels, flights, all that kind of stuff. And you can also shortcut to the activities list right from control center. Have the Tripsy action right here, and it opens the app. And once you've built your trips in the app, it'll shortcut right to there. All right, we're in the home stretch. The next app is called Structured. Again, I talked about this in my widget app, but kudos to Structured for having so many different actions. It's kind of a task, schedule, events application, keeping it all organized. And you can have all these different actions in the control center, from starting a focus, adding an inbox task, a bunch of different things. So highly recommend trying it out if you want to organize your events, tasks, all in one place. Number 31, there's an app called Focus, which is great if you're trying to do like Pomodoro timing, or you just want to set timers to be able to focus on specific tasks. You can start that timer right from control center. And there's a bunch of actions as well. You can end or skip the session, extend the session right from the control center, create a new task in Focus, and more. And number 32, you know I had to mention it, talking about control center actions, is Shortcuts. You can open the Shortcuts app, but more importantly, you can program shortcuts to run right here in Control Center. Choose from your entire list of shortcuts. As you can see, I have a few, and then you can run them directly in Control Center. To be honest, I haven't decided all the shortcuts I want to run in Control Center, but I do have my recording video shortcut, which changes the brightness level on my iPhone, sets a HomeKit scene, and more. I'm going to play around with it over the next couple weeks, and I'll show you my Shortcuts Control Center setup soon. Another great reason to subscribe to the channel, hit that like button, and if you want to learn more about shortcuts, I have an entire playlist going from Shortcuts 101, building on those actions, automations, and even expert level shortcuts. Check out that playlist right up here. If you have any questions, leave comments below this video. Let me know if there's any third-party apps you've seen that have great control center actions that I missed in this video. And if you want to learn about everything new in iOS 18, which is over 95 new features, I did an entire video on that. I'll link it right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.